Welcome back to Overtime here on WOTM. We will continue our Who's Better segment. We had baseball for the last two, and we'll continue with the baseball theme, except this time we'll take on two different players who suited up for the Atlanta Braves in both Andrew Jones and Marquise Grissom. Now, off the top of my head, whenever we do these things, off the top of my head, I always think, okay, I know who initially I want, and then I want to dive into the numbers, and that's something that you do really well. As you were putting this little conglomerate together between very athletic players that played for a long time, kind of household names in baseball, especially in their era, what were some of the things that popped out to you?
Well, to me, these are two players that when their skills necessarily aren't as similar as I thought they might be, because mm-hmm. Andrew Jones is much more of a power hitter than Marquise Grissom was, but they were both mainstays on teams that made the postseason yep. consistently in the 90s and 2000s. Marquise Grissom was a guy that the Braves got from the Expos. If you remember who they traded for him, they traded Roberto Kelly being mm-hmm. one of the major parts of that deal. So he comes over to Atlanta. After Atlanta has lost in the 91 World Series, 92 World Series, and 93 NLCS, and in that very first postseason, 95, hits 524 against Colorado, and hits over 360 in a World Series against Cleveland, including making the final out and giving the Braves their only world championship of, you know, since they moved to Atlanta.
Right.
So he's very special to Braves fans because he was part of that team. Andrew Jones joined the fray in 96. He introduced himself into the postseason baseball world, hitting two home runs off the Yankees in game one of the 1996 World Series at 19 years old.
Yep.
The earliest, the youngest player to do so. And then you saw Jones' career kind of take off after that. So looking at the numbers overall, they're very close as far as games played, as far as plate appearances. Batting average is a little bit one-sided because Jones wasn't much of an average hitter, especially toward the end of his career,
right,
where he really dropped off. But a lot of these categories are similar. You expect Jones to have more home runs. You expect Jones to have more RBIs because he was a power hitter. Runs scored, I thought, would be even, and they just about were, 1,200
right.
to 1,187. Stolen bases, Grissom was better. And then overall OPS, you expect Jones to be better because he hit for more power. And then in the outfield, as far as outfielders, Grissom was a very good center fielder, but Jones was probably the greatest defensive center fielder I've ever seen.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just kind of unfair to compare him. Looking at their postseason numbers, Grissom, a very, very good postseason area.
Oh, yeah.
As you know from the Braves winning the World
yep.
Series, 95. 97 with the Indians, wind up winning the the American League Championship Series MVP. Same amount of hits, four different RBIs. You don't expect Grissom to have as much runs scored. Andrew Jones surprised me a little bit. More runs scored. And Grissom, a guy, again, who got some get on base and steal bases. Overall OPS, Grissom higher
exactly.
than Jones,
yep.
which surprises me. Then if you look at the next category, which is awards won, prime years. I'm having a little problem following which graphic
and,
after another.
And on those prime years,
yep.
we talked about it yesterday, being age 24 to 31.
Right.
What years did you look at
okay.
here? Maybe not age, but maybe seasons in the leagues.
Right. Now, because Jones came in at 19, I had to do it a little differently.
Yeah.
So I took 8 years in their prime. Jones, it was from 22 to 30.
Mm-hmm.
Grissom, it was from his second year in the league until his ninth year. So it was like both over 8 year spans for
right.
them. And because you had to make the seasons and the games pretty much equal each other. So this was a lot closer than I thought it would be, because I thought Jones' power numbers would be enough to where he really separates himself.
Yeah.
And you could see, obviously, 35 home runs, 14 home runs, 104 RBIs to 63 RBIs. But runs scored, Grissom is able to, 99 to 87 for Grissom, who wasn't really an on-base guy.
Yeah.
He never walked. He was a guy that relied on a lot of hits. And for only 162 hits, that's not bad. Grissom made the most of when he got on base. OPS, again, was something that Jones had a little higher. That number is supposed to be in the 700s for Grissom. So Jones beat him in that. And overall, I think Jones' power numbers were just a little too hard to ignore. Even in looking at the overall awards won for the both of them, Jones didn't win an MVP. Both of them are probably not going to be Hall of Famers. And Gold Gloves, like we said, Andrew Jones was one of the best center fielders to ever play baseball. In the All-Star games, Jones had 5 All-Star games to Marcus Grissom's 2 All-Star games. So Jones, to me, had better numbers overall as far as being hardware with Gold Gloves, even though Grissom won the only MVP of the two in the postseason. And Grissom's postseason numbers were very good. Andrew Jones, the one thing that I would say why I wouldn't take him, even though I'm going to take him, you can make an argument that Andrew Jones just fell off of the tank or off of the grid so badly after he left Atlanta that there was no kind of redeeming his career. We're talking about after he left Atlanta in 2008, where he was still young in his early 30s, 32 years old, hitting 158 with the Dodgers and never ever getting back to a player that could be an everyday player. He never was after that.
Yep.
He had a year in 2006 or 2005 where he had 50 home runs, and then since then, the next year at 34, and then he just totally dropped off. So that I can't explain.
Right.
But if you look at the overall numbers and for their careers and in the postseason, again, Jones still played 14 productive seasons overall compared to Grissom, who, even though he started a little bit later, Grissom to me was a guy that was a very good center fielder on very good teams. He could be part of a championship team, as we saw he was, but he wasn't going to make consistent plays year after year to where he's among the league's top run producers and batting average guys. He would be a nice fit in, like Roberto Kelly, who he was traded for. I think that's more of his game, where Jones is more of a guy who you knew he was going to be a dominant player in the lineup. And for about 5-6 years with Chipper Jones and Sheffield and Galarraga and some of the other guys they paired him with, Andrew Jones was a tough out. He was a guy I feared going against as a pitcher, watching the Mets play them. And even though he didn't have the overall numbers as far as batting average, he still got a lot of clutch hits, never made an error, never seemed to make a running mistake, and was just an overall great talent. So I would say in their career, Andrew Jones is better. But I think this is very interesting because the way that these two players, their strengths are a little different, but they're very similar as far as helping a team win and doing the little things, especially defensively and running the bases. Two of the best base runners of that era, and two of the best defensive players of that era.
Especially on defense, and when we first kind of threw this up, the very first thing I thought of was, this is going to be Andrew Jones in a landslide.
Right, no heartbeat, right.
I do think that the height, the peak of his powers, Andrew Jones is the better of the peak of the power, Jones to Grissom one-on-one. If I needed a bat and I needed a runner in the postseason, I think I'm going Grissom hands down. I think he's a better postseason player. Longevity, I do think you're right. I mean, overall, I do think that Jones is a little bit better. And, of course, defensively, with those 10 Gold Gloves, is something that you really cannot overlook. And I think they're borderline Hall of Famers. They'll get enough votes to be respected. They will never – I don't think any one of them is going to make it into Cooperstown. But I do think that it's not – it's closer than I thought when I first heard the two names. You just – going off reputation, I thought it was going to be a little bit closer.
And it's funny because a lot had to do with the other getting traded. Because when Andrew came up at 1996, Marquis was the everyday center fielder, and then his presence made him expendable. So if you remember who he got traded for, two very popular players, David Justice and Marquis Grissom, got traded to Cleveland for Kenny Lofton. And Kenny Lofton played that 1 year in 97 with the Braves and then wound up going back to Cleveland as a free agent. They couldn't re-sign him. And I thought that really broke up some guys that Atlanta fans had grown up with. They grew up with David Justice, a guy that was there from the early 90s. Got a lot of big hits. Even after he left the Braves, were on postseason teams with the Yankees that won the World Series. Very good postseason player. And Grissom in 97, a huge part of the Indian team that almost won the World Series, and in that the division series against the Yankees, playing very well, and in the championship series against Baltimore, winning the MVP, getting them over the top. So we're talking about guys that did different things for their teams, but if they would have stayed together in Atlanta, maybe they would have been able to balance out that lineup more. Where you had Grissom was a tough out. And he extended the at-bat. He wasn't going to strike out. And I think Atlanta, when they went to the more power lineups of the late 90s, where they would win 103, 104 games during the regular season, but they lost in 97 to the Marlins and 98 to the Padres, teams they should not have lost to. And also remember, in 96, they fell behind 3-1 to the Cardinals before rallying to win that one. So there were a lot of things that or games and seasons where fans expected Atlanta to get back to the World Series and win another one, and they never did. So maybe with Marquise, they would have been able to do that.
The great what-ifs in sports and in life, and I think that's one of the better ones, and one of the ones that the Atlanta Braves fans will be worrying about for, or be thinking about for a long time with that club and the potential of what it could have been. But another great Who's Better installment and the second one of the week. Appreciate all your hard work on that. Well, coming up next here on Overtime, we'll stay in baseball. We'll go to the college level. One SEC team is gone. Two are still in Omaha. We'll talk about it coming up next.